Friends, we have been doing shear force and bending moment diagram. In the previous clip, we had solved problems on three cantilever beams. Now I am taking up simply supported beams. You will get two problems, one on cantilever beam and the other one on simply supported beam. We have done three problems on that. We will do a few problems here. I have selected from your question bank problem number 15. Problem number 15, it goes like this. A simply supported beam of length 6 meter carries point loads of 2 kN, 4 kN and 5 kN at distances of 1 meter, 3 meter and 4 meters from the left support respectively. Draw SF and BM diagrams for the beam. So first I have taken a beam, a problem having only point loads. So the length of the beam is, first draw a figure. The length of the beam is 6 meters, right? This is 6 meter from here to here, from one support to the other support, that is extreme ends. 1 meter from here, 1 meter, let us say this is 1 meter, then 3 meters means somewhere here, 1 meter, 3 meters and 4 meters, 4 meters from the left support, from the left support. This is 1 meter from the left support, all distances from left support. You have to read the problem carefully and first mark it. 3 meters, this distance is 3 meters. From here to here it is 4 meters. That means this will be 2 meters. This will be 2 meters, that will be 2 meters. Here, first load is 2 kN. So this is 2 kN. This is 4 kN and this is 5 kN. 5 kN. So three forces like this. First, you have to read the problem carefully and draw the figure. Now, on this beam, you can see there are 5 forces acting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In previous cases, that is in cantilever beam, there used to be only one support. So we used to simply add these and this reaction will be equal to the sum of all that we used to put. But here there are two reactions, two unknown forces, and we have these known forces. Now first what we have to do is we have to find out this unknown forces, the reactions. We have to find out this reaction here and that reaction. I will call this as A, this as B, this as C, this as D and this as E. So 5 points are there. So this reaction will be called as RA, reaction at A, and this will be called as reaction at E. Right. Now first thing I have to do is find out the value of RA and RE. Now to find this, what we do always in a simply supported beam, the procedure is like this. See, if the beam is to be in equilibrium, sum of upward forces must be equal to sum of downward forces. So upward forces, there are two, that is RA plus RE. Downward forces, there are 3, 2 plus 4 plus 5. So RA plus RE will be equal to 11 kN. 11 kilonewtons. This first you have to get. After this, what you have to do is, you have to take the moments of all forces either here or here, where we have an unknown force. Better we take at A. Taking moments of all forces at A. Now, leaving this Ra, because the moment of Ra will be 0 at this point, because the distance is 0, Ra into 0 will be 0. This force is exerting a moment and the direction is clockwise. This is clockwise, this is also clockwise, this is anti-clockwise. So there are totally four moments. One of them is anti-clockwise, the other three are clockwise moments. So for equilibrium, sum of anti-clockwise moments must be equal to sum of clockwise moments. Now, using this principle, what will happen? Re, that is the force, this force we don't know it, Re into this distance, because we are taking the moments at A, Re into 6 is equal to 5 into 4 plus 4 into 3 plus 2 into 1, all I have taken at A. So 6 Re will be equal to 34 will be the total of this. 5 into 4 plus 4 into 3 plus 2 into 1 will give me 34. 5 into 4 plus 4 into 3 plus 2 is equal to 34. So Re will be equal to 34 by 6. Answer divided by 6 will give me 5.66666, like that. So I'll approximate it as 5.67 kilonewtons. So this I got as roughly 5.67 kilonewton. Now this will be, we know Ra plus Re is, we have got this as 11 kilonewton here. So Ra will be 11 minus Re, that is 11 minus 5.67. This will work out to 5.33 kilonewton. So approximately this will be 5.33 kilonewton. That will be 5.67. Now, after this, this is the first thing that we have to do. In a simply supported beam, before you calculate SF and BM, you have to first find out the reactions. The reactions have to be found out like this. For the beam to be in equilibrium, the sum of upward forces must be equal to downward forces. Then taking moments at one of the unknown points, the sum of clockwise moments must be equal to sum of anti-clockwise moments. Now we have got these two reactions. Now SF calculations. SF calculations, SF at E, SF at D, SF at C, SF at B, and SF at A. So these are the five salient points, important points. SF at E is plus 5.67, because that is upward force. Upward we are taking as plus, so it is 5.67. At D, when you come to D, plus 5.67 minus 5, that is 0.67 kilonewton. Next, when you come to this C, you have a balance of, this is plus 0.67 minus 4, that is minus 3.33 kilonewton. Here the balance is minus 3.33 minus again 2, that will be minus 5.33 kilonewton, and here it will become 0, minus 5.33 plus 5.33. It should become 0 here at this point. So this is SF calculation. SF calculation. Now the bending moment calculation will be like this. Bending moment calculation will be, again, BM at E, BM at D, BM at C, BM at B, BM at A. 5 points, 5 salient points. BM at E plus 5.67 minus, into 0. Only one force there, distance is 0. At D, it will be plus 5.67 multiplied by this distance. This is 6 minus 4, that is 2, minus 5 into 0. Then when you come to C, plus 5.67, you have moved how much? From here to here, this is 4, this is 3, so this distance is 1 meter. So it was 2 here, now it becomes 3. It becomes 3 minus 5 into 1 minus 4 into 0. 4 into 0. Then you come to B here, you have moved another 2 meters. This is 3, this is 1. So plus 5.67 into 5, it becomes 5 now, minus 5 into 3, 5 into 3 from here to here, then minus 4 into 2. Then at A, it will be plus 5.67 into 6, 1 more meter we are moving this side. Minus 5 into 4, minus 4 into 3, minus 2 into 1, plus 5.33 multiplied by 0. So the first one is 0 here. The last one also must be 0. Let us see. 5.67 into 2 minus 0, that is 11.34 kilonewton meter. Then 5.67 into 3 minus 5 into 1, that will give me 12.01. You can take it as 12 only. Then here here I have left minus 2 into 0. 5.67 into 5 minus 5 into 3 minus 4 into 2 equals 5.35. Here 5.67 into 6 minus 5 into 4 minus 4 into 3 minus 2 into 1 is equal to, I should get here 0. I am getting it as 0.02. That is because I have taken this as 5 instead of 5.666. I have taken it as 5.67. And here it will be 5.333, but I have taken, but you must take it as 0. It should come very close to 0. If you're not 0, it should come very close to 0 and it should be taken as 0. And in the simply supported beam, the end will be 0, both in SF and BM. Now project these points down, thin lines, draw thin lines here. Draw a zero line, leave some gap. Here it is plus 5.67. This is 5.67. From here to here it is same. Then it will fall 5 here. So only plus 0.67. Then here it will fall another 4. And it becomes minus 3.33 here. Then it will fall further to here. And it will become like this. These are all point loads. So this SFD will be like this. This is the SFD. It will be a closed figure. A closed figure. Here it is positive. Here it is negative. This point where the shear force changes its sign, it becomes from plus to negative, positive to negative or negative to positive, there bending moment will be maximum. You see at C, it is the maximum bending moment. This is called as the point of contraflexure. So this is your SFD. This is our SFD. Then project these further down. Leave some space here. Draw a horizontal line. This is 0, this is 0. Here it is. Here it is. 11.34. Here it is 12. Not much difference. Here it is 5.35. Here again 5.35. It is 0. Now these are all point loads. So these will be straight lines. Join them by straight lines. If it is UDL, it will be this thing. You mark these values here. This is, it is 5.35. Here it is 12. Here it is 11.34. There it is 0. This is 0. This is also a closed figure. This is your BMD, bending moment diagram. This is how it is to be done. This is one problem. Usually this problem will carry 10 marks. It will have 10 marks. Let's take a next one more problem. Problem number 17. I have chosen a problem here where it's a simply supported beam having only one UDL, one uniformly distributed load. After that, I will do a combination of both. That is both UDL as well as point loads. So we have done one problem having only point loads, one having only UDL, and then we will take up one problem having both UDL and this thing. The problem is 17 from the question bank. It goes like this. A simply supported beam of length 8 meters. So the span is 8 meters. This is one reaction. This is the other reaction. This length is 8 meters. It carries a UDL of 10 kilonewton per meter for a distance of 6 meter from left support. From the left support up to a distance of 6 meters. That means 2 meters there is a gap. This is the UDL. The UDL is 10 kilonewton per meter for 6 meters starting from the left support. So this is the diagram. This is the figure. Now when you get UDL, it is always better that we convert it into a point load. So this is one reaction, this is another reaction. Now this is up to here, there is load. This is 10 kilonewton per meter for a distance of 6 meters. So 10 into 6, that will give me 60 kilonewtons. 60 kilonewton acting at the middle of this. At the middle of this. That is, this is 3, this is 3, this is 2. 6 meters exactly in the middle, you have 60 kilonewton point load. I have replaced the UDL by a point load. I will call this point as A, this as B, this as C, and this as D. So this will be now reaction at A and this will be reaction at B. Now we have to first again find out the reactions. The procedure is always the same. We have to first thing is sum of upward forces, that is Ra plus Rd is equal to sum of downward forces. There is only one downward force, that is 60 kilonewton. So Ra plus Rd must be equal to 60 kilonewtons. Then taking moments above at A, taking moments at A, sum of anti-clockwise moments must be equal to sum of clockwise moments. So anti-clockwise one moment, clockwise one moment only. So Rd into 6, Rd into, sorry, 8, Rd into 8, from here to here, Rd into 8 is equal to 60 into 3. So 8 Rd is equal to 180. So Rd will be equal to 180 divided by 8. It will be 22.5 kilonewton. This is Rd. Rd will be 22.5 kilonewton. Ra will be Ra plus Rd is 60. So Ra will be 60 minus Rd, that is 60 minus 22.5. This will be 37.5 kilonewton. Right? So this is 37.5. So first you do this. Next, what we have to do is we have to do calculations. Calculation of SF and BM calculations, then draw the figures. So first we will take up SF calculation. SF calculations. So from that side, SF at B, that is upward, so plus 22.5 kilonewton. SF at C, there is no force here to here, so it will be 22.5 only, plus 22.5 kilonewton. Then you come to SF at B, here it will be plus 22.5 minus 60, that is minus 37.5 kilonewton. And SF at A will be minus 37.5. This will be plus because this is upward, plus 37.5, that is zero. I hope you have understood. This is the SF calculation. Next comes BM calculation. BM calculation will be like this. Again, BM at D. BM at D plus 22.5 into 0. Starting will be 0. Next, BM at C plus 22.5 into 2. That is 45 kilonewton meter. Then BM at B plus 22.5 into this distance from here to here is now 2 plus 3, that is 5 meters minus 60 into 0. 60 into 0. Then BM at A will be 22.5 into 8 minus 60 into 3. So 45, this will be 22.5 into 5 minus 60 into 0. 22.5 into 5. That will give me 112.5 kilonewton meter. So now you have these values, you have to plot it here. Now shear force diagram will come like this, plus 22.5, up to here it is same, plus 22.5, then here also it should come same, like this, minus 60, that means 37.5, minus 37.5, like this. Now if this was a point load, it would have come like this only, but now it is not a point load, so this will be horizontal here, this is vertical. Now this will, you will have to join this to this, it will come like this. So it will come like this. This is the SFD, this is the SFD, here it is negative, shear force is negative, here it is positive, it will not pass through that point, little that side. So this is your SFD. BMD will come like this, take it down, here it is 0, here also it is 0, here it is 45, here it is 112.5, here it is 0, this is 45, this is 112.5, here it will be a inclined line, because it is, it's a point load there, no UDL here, it will come like this, then it will come like this here. This is how it will come, this is the BMD, this is the BMD, you will get like this. This is your BMD, right? So these are the figures. If you have any problem, any doubt, you can ask me over phone, you can contact me and get the clarifications. Thank you.